So we had started with the dot product yesterday, the scalar product, and we saw some 7 observations related with that. Now we come to 2 properties of, let me recap. A dot B we had studied to be mod A mod B cos theta. And how had we defined that? This is A, this is B, this is theta. So we make it co-initial and then find the smaller angle between the 2 vectors, right? That's how we had defined A dot B as equal to mod A mod B cos theta. Fine. We had also seen that depending on that, based on that definition, the standard unit vectors, when dotted with the others, they'll give us this. Okay. Fine. So now we come to 2 properties of dot product. One of them is the distributive property, that is, if A is dotted with B plus C, it gives us actually A dot B plus A dot C. So what do we say? We say that the multiplication, the dot multiplication, distributes over the addition in the same way as we have seen in the numbers. 2 into 3 plus 4 is 2 into 3 plus 2 into 4, which is equal to 6 plus 8, which is equal to 14. Okay, it is the same kind of thing that is happening. Okay, the distributive property holds. Now the second property is, if I have lambda times A dotted with B, okay, then that is equal to lambda A dot B, or that is also equal to A dot lambda B. Okay, so that is also A dot lambda B. Not only that, I'd also like to draw your attention to this. If there is lambda 1 A dotted with lambda 2 B, then we tend to get lambda 1 lambda 2 A dot B, and that means they can be switched, they can be brought out, they can be, okay, so this is also equal to lambda 2 A dot lambda 1 B and so on. Okay, now these 2 are very, very important theorems which will help us in finding out what in real life the dot products are. Okay, so if we are given 2 vectors, let there be 2 vectors A is equal to A1 I cap plus A2 J cap plus A3 K cap, and B is equal to B1 I cap plus B2 J cap plus B3 K cap. Okay, what happens if I dot them? So A dot B gives me A1 I cap
a1i cap
plus a2j cap plus a3k cap dotted with b1i cap plus b2j cap plus b3k cap.
And I'll apply my distributive property. Okay,
so what happens? A1i cap gets, A1i cap is dotted with B1i cap. A1i cap gets dotted with B2j cap. A1i cap gets dotted with B3k cap plus A2j cap gets dotted with B1i cap. A2j cap gets dotted with B2j cap plus A2j cap gets dotted with B3k cap plus A3k cap gets dotted with B1i cap plus A3k cap gets dotted with B2j cap plus A3k cap gets dotted with B3k cap. Now that gives us A1 B1 I cap dot I cap plus A1 B2 I cap dot J cap A1 B3 I cap dot K cap plus A2 B1 J cap dot I cap plus A2 B2 J cap dot J cap plus A2 B3 J cap dot K cap plus A3 B1 K cap dot I cap plus A3 B2 K cap dot J cap plus A3 B3 K cap dot K cap. Now you see, I'll use this. That's why I had deliberately left it. Got deleted a bit. Wait. This was I cap dot K cap. I'll use them. Okay. So I cap dot I cap is 1. And this goes to 0. And this goes to 0. Why? I dot j is 0 and I dot k is 0. So I'm left with a1, b1. Right? Then a2, b1. Right? A2, B1, that also goes to 0, J dot I. A2, B2 remains, right? So A2, B2 remains. So I'll mark it by red. This term remains, and this term remains. Rest all go to 0. Okay, so A1, B1 plus A2, B2 plus A3, B3. Now that's a very simple kind of thing to understand. What have we done? What happens is this. You just have to multiply the corresponding I coefficients, J coefficients and K coefficients and just add them. Okay, it's as simple as that. So if maybe A is equal to I cap plus 2j cap plus 3k cap and B is 2i cap minus 3j cap plus 5k cap, then what happens? A dot B will give you 1 into 2 into minus 3 minus 6, 3 into 5 15, that is equal to 11. It is a scalar, right? That's how we get the value of A dot B. We understand?